Kerry then, 3 Kerry, so hooked to hooked. 4,380.
Into the back lanes of every town and village in the country. We know every one of them. We know the people. And they know us.
And
I guarantee you, we'll never shut off our phone and we'll never depart from the people. We'll stay with the people. Other parties have forgotten about the people and they're thinking about Dublin and they're thinking of other areas, ideas. All we want to do is to help the people that we're serving. And if God spares us the help, we'll continue to do that while we can. And once the people elect us, we certainly will try to do our best for them. And if we fail, no other one will come behind us and do better than us or succeed in doing what we're after failing to do, because we'll try to the bitter end. And there are many things that people are suffering for today. Taking it certainly hurt him a lot and he couldn't come out to vote for his first grandson, Johnny Healy-Rae, because I know that that's what he wanted to do for the last 2 or 3 weeks. He had, for the first election in 60 years, that he won that to come. And I know that because I've been at the very emotional meeting from the 70s on anyway. And I was side by side with him, shoulder to shoulder, and I know he's hoping deeply to the end that he couldn't be at this call, because this would be so precious to him to see both me and Johnny being elected and in such a strong fashion as we performed here today. But again, I see the people, because this has been a tough election.
And you must remember what we're up against at all times. I've seen situations where government ministers have laughed at me when I've been attacking them above and side in the dark. And they've hurt their own county councillors. But I will remind the people of one thing. When I was tackling Phil Hogan one day about what he was doing to the people in the country, he said, "Tell them I'm quaking in my boots." And he got a big fit of laughing. Well, I have a message for Phil Hogan now. You'd want to watch who's laughing now, because he made a big mistake in hurting the people of Ireland in the way that he did. And so did many more of them, including Mr. Shatter, that had to resign, who closed our rural Garda stations. And Riley, another man that has a lot to answer for. But these are the mistakes that these politicians have made. But
cheer again, sir. What?
I believe
it's
about
but we'll have the last laugh at that fellow problem.